All right, so we're going to take a few minutes to show you how to prepare your comps for FTPing. So up to this point, you should have designed your comps, and once they're completely ready to go, you're going to need to save them as a JPEG. So up until this point, if you've never done web design before, you're probably used to the save as dialog box, and you've got options for various types of files. I'm going to discourage you guys from using save as, because if you use save as, it keeps the same resolution and the same color mode. So usually we want to compress our files a little bit better than what the save as dialog box gives us. So through Photoshop, there's also an option to save for the web, and you'll find it under export. So we're going to choose that. And by default, there are a few different viewing options, and we're going to choose the four up option so that we can actually look closely at our file. Now for comps, because there are usually photographs in multiple colors, usually we're going to stick to keeping a JPEG, which will support millions of colors. Just quickly though, I'll show you guys the difference between a JPEG, a GIF, and then a PNG. Now when we get a little bit further into the course, we're going to learn how to break down images a little bit further than this, but just so you guys can see the difference. So I've got the JPEG here at 60 quality, which is a pretty good kind of beginning level estimate for most images that are JPEG. And this is 532 kilobytes, which is about half a megabyte. And then we've got the GIF image, which I think if we zoom in just a little bit more, you might see some of the problems with the GIF image. GIFs aren't meant for photographs, so you might start to see like the quality in the photo degrade, and it also has a lot of trouble compressing the file if it's partly a photograph. So you can also see it up here, how this does not look as nice as that. And then we've got the option for PNG, which PNG 24 is pretty common. It supports some transparency and stuff, so that's nice sometimes, but look at the difference in the file. It's almost 2 megabytes. So when we're working for the web, we want to keep in mind that the person on the other end is going to have to download this image. So if you compare the JPEG and the PNG, they're not too far off from one another, and we don't really need transparency with our comps. So we're going to save that as a JPEG. Now you can click the save button and go ahead and save it. I've already optimized these though, so I'm going to show you guys my organization before we go forward. So in the folder that I've got for the project, I've got one folder that inside of it I've got images, and you can see the three comps. So you guys should have however many are required for your project. And then we've got each of them as a JPEG. Now the nice thing is you can see how large they are right here through your files panel usually, as well as the dimensions of the image. And those are usually pixel dimensions. And then we've got the HTML page that I've started for you guys. So basically you've got to have them optimized first. And then what we're going to do is we're going to post them up to a website, which we'll show you on another screencast. So I need you to basically create one HTML page just to link to the images. It makes presentation a lot easier. So we're going to go through the process of how we do this. So you set up your core HTML with your doc type, your head portion of your document, your title, as well as the image link right here. Okay, and this right now is just linking to one of our images. And we can now preview it, which if I make it a little bit bigger, you can see the whole view. And then we can just scroll down the page and look at the image, okay? So the goal is that we're able to present our comps in class and that we can critique one another. So we've got to add the other two images though. And so what I'm going to do is, because I've already created that image code, I'm just going to duplicate it. And then we're going to change out the data that's different so that each of those images shows up. So we've got about, donate, and then home. And just a little reminder with link paths, when you're creating a link to an image, this first part is referring to our folder here, Okay. And then the forward slash just basically lets us go forward and call the image name. You do want to make sure you're naming with all lowercase, no spaces, and no special characters. The alt attribute is the description for the page. So if somebody does not have the ability to view your images, whether your link is incorrect or maybe they have vision problems, they will see this in its place, or they'll have a screen reader read it to them. So let's see, we've got image dimensions are the same for the first two, and the last two is slightly different, so we're going to change that. You do want to make sure you have the correct width and height, or it might distort your image. So I'm just looking at this number right here. We can then test it. And then you can see basically that we've got each image. Now, if you notice that your images show up side by side, images are inline elements. So if you needed to, you could put a like a BR tag for a line break. In this case, my browser is not wide enough to do that, but if you have a wider monitor screen, you may notice that. So basically just link to your images, save it. We're gonna test it. And we're able to see it right now. This is Chrome. And just scroll through and make sure all your images appear and appear in the order that you want them. And then from there, the next step is going to be FTPing, which we'll show you guys how to do that in another screencast. So hopefully that helps you understand how you prepare your images for presentation online. And then we'll have another screencast for FTP coming up soon.